Hey guys, this week it's going to be a little bit different of a review, being as you read in the title, it's a movie review. I haven't done one of these in a really long time, and I asked as a vote on Twitter, had you guys vote, would you rather have me do a review of Alice in Wonderland, the movie, or do the Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 review, and put that up this week, since I already have it pre-recorded, still trying to get it out to you guys, and you guys voted Alice in Wonderland over Call of Duty, so that's going to be hopefully next week, unless I gotta look and see, I still might have some other reviews I didn't put out either, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to make that one next week for you guys, so look forward to that. And anyways, if you aren't following me on Twitter, follow me on Twitter at @GodIsMyRock, twitter.com/@GodIsMyRock, okay, I mean /GodIsMyRock, no at, but anyways, Alice in Wonderland, it was released on March 5th, 2010, obviously, the new one, the one that just came out on March 5th, 2010, 5 days ago from today. Well, it might be 6 days ago. Anyways, let's get into the review. I'm just rambling on here. So, Alice in Wonderland, what the basic of storyline is it's not the original one, which I was confused. I didn't do any research on this movie before I saw it. I went to the theater and saw it a couple days ago, and I thought that it was just a remake of the original, like it was going to be all the exact same thing, or I mean to a degree, follow the same storyline and be the exact remake. To my surprise, it was very different. Basically, Alice comes back to Wonderland as an adult, or a young adult, yeah, older, she's whatever she is, 19, 20, I don't remember, 18, she's older than she was. So what they were portraying is that the first time she was there was when she was younger, when she was about 5. In the beginning, it kind of fills you in on that and how that is. It's kind of confusing if you go into the movie with the mindset of, okay, it's the original story, right? The same one that we've all seen when we were little. So there we go. That's the basic storyline. It's a continuation. She comes back. So remember that. Keep that in your head as you go into the movie. That will make things a lot more clear to you. And to go along with that, basically, I think the original was much better. Maybe because I was a little kid when I saw it. Probably, yes. This one, it had so much hype for it, just because Johnny Depp was in it, basically, in my opinion, that's why. And I think it was not worth the hype at all, whatsoever. I seriously, if you watch my vlogs every day, by the way, that's also, you can find that on my channel, GIMRVLOGS, youtube.com/GIMRVLOGS. Check that out. Do vlogs every day. Anyways, I told you guys there that I came out of the movie and the first thing I thought was, what other ways could I have spent that $7 on that movie? Because it wasn't worth it. That's my opinion. Some people are going to disagree. But the people that I went with, I think, also agreed with me. I know there was at least 2 or 3 other people in the group of 6 or 7, but I didn't talk to all of them. So, yeah, that said that it was no good. It just was, I don't know, it just wasn't up to par with what I was expecting. And I really wasn't expecting much because I'm not really interested in it, but I just went to see it just because everyone's seen that movie in their childhood. So I figured I'd give it a shot, right? Just hang out with some friends, spend some time. So let's get it. I'm not going to go into the storyline too deep because I don't want to ruin it for you guys, for you those of you that actually want to see it. And by the way, I do not recommend seeing it. Maybe, I guess, I don't know. I wouldn't recommend buying it either, but you can buy it in the description if you want. There's a link in the description to go buy it when it's out on DVD and Blu-ray and all that good stuff. But in the theater, I'd say don't do it in the theater. Don't watch it in the theater. Wait till it comes out on DVD/Blu-ray. Have someone else buy it and go watch it at their house if you really want to see it that bad. But it's not. I would not pay the money. I really would not pay the money. Even if you have a little kid, they're not really going to get it. I don't think they're going to understand it, in my opinion. When I was in the theater, it was mostly adults, and like, I mean, my age and older people that were in the theater. There wasn't a whole lot of little kids. And going through the movie, I don't think little kids are really going to understand it. So for those of you who are adults that watch this and are doing it for, going to go watching the review to see if it's worth it for your children, I'd say don't even bring them. That's my opinion. You don't even go yourself either, I would say. But, you know, there's other stuff that you could watch it. They'd enjoy more. And as far as the casting, I guess it was fine. There was no big problems with it. I honestly expected the Mad Hatter to be a little bit more weird than he was. He was weird, though. Johnny Depp did do a good job. I'll give him props for it. But without him in the movie, with being the Mad Hatter, or even just having that character in there play such a main role, I'd say the movie would just be complete trash, because it already is kind of trash, but it's definitely really garbage if he wasn't in there. So he did make the movie a lot of what it is, in my opinion. The story of the movie was not very good either. I didn't like it. I didn't think it was good. So thumbs down on that. I'm trying to think of what else I have to go through. I didn't do any preparation for this review, so I'm just kind of off the top of my head. And I also don't do movie reviews a lot, so I don't really know what points to cover in the movie. So I hope that's kind of everything that I should go over for you guys. If you really want to know more detail, you can read in the description or down below if you're on the website or wherever. Look around for the text that goes with it. There's a full written review with this video as well that should be out a couple days after this review's up. So you can read the full review if I missed anything in this video review. So go check that out if you want more details. And I'd say it's a thumbs down not to really go by it. I wouldn't recommend it, but you can in the description if you'd like. And also, if you want to support me and you don't want to support me by buying the DVD/Blu-ray, you can buy one of these shirts. If you can't see, it says, "Do work, son." It's got a little three stars and a little line thing. You can buy these shirts. They're in the description as well. There's another couple shirts I think I made as well, plus the Extreme Days originals. You can buy those. It helps support me. If not, okay. I'm really proud of this one, though. It came out really nicely, so for those of you that are wondering. You can get it in lots of different colors. Mine's purple, because I thought it was cool. But that's about it for the Alice in Wonderland review. Thumbs down, like I said. I don't think there's anything else I really need to cover, but I'd say it's not worth your money. So I will see you next week.